Dear student, today I am going to solve unit test 2 for 9th standard physics. Let's see how to understand the concept of the asked question in exam. First of all, I want to solve first question. Let's see the first question here. Where should a solid weigh more, in air or liquid? Let's see. Answer is in air. Reason, because buoyancy in air, buoyant force in air, that will be less as compared to buoyant force in water or liquid. That's why if buoyant force is more, it means weight will be less. By this way, you can conclude in air, weight is more than the weight in liquid. This is the first. Solution of second question. Let's see. A ball is thrown vertically upward with velocity. Initial velocity of the ball is given, that is 40 meter per second. G you have to take 10 meters per second square, and n at what time you need to calculate the distance. Time is given, that is 4 seconds. Let's see. This is the surface through which ball is thrown up with initial velocity u, and finally let ball is reached at the highest point, final velocity become 0. Gravity will act downward direction. This is u. Now you need to use the sign convention. In upward direction take positive, in downward direction you have to take it a negative. You can apply, first of all calculate the time. You can use the Galileo's equation, v is equal to u plus gt. You know at the highest point velocity become 0. Therefore 0 is equal to u is upward, that's why it will be positive. How much it is? That is given 40. G is downward, that's why I can take it t minus 10, and that is t. T you can get 4 seconds. It means time required to go up to this height, we need 4 seconds. Now how much distance is traveled? You can use s is equal to ut plus half a t square. S is what? S is the distance. Now I can write distance is equal to u is given, that is 40. Time I have calculated, that is 4 seconds minus half, g is 10, and time is square of the 4. You will finally get 160, 40 into 4, 160 minus 4 fours are 16, 16 by 2, 8 into 10, that is 80. And finally that will be 80 meters. What is the distance? That will be 80 meters. Now you need to find out the second part, time required to return back on the earth. You know total time is what? Time of ascent, upward direction, and time of descent, that is downward direction. Time of ascent is 4 seconds. They are equal in free fall motion. That's why 4 plus 4, you will get 8 seconds is the answer. Now question number 3. Let's see the question number 3 here. Explain why an iron nail sinks in water but iron ships floats. It depends upon the shape. Shape means density of any body depends upon the volume. You know, volume of the iron nail is less and volume of the ship is more. That's why density of iron is greater than density of ship. That's why it will sink. Now question number 4, let's see. What change will be observed when force of gravitation, means to say what is the change? Force of gravitation, you know, that is g m1 m2 upon r square. Now according to question, what is given? I already solved in the Ntse solution this. G mass is, one mass is twice m1, another mass is half m2 by 2, and distance between them is also half, that is r by 2 ka whole square. When you solve it, that will be 2, 2 will cancel out here, and 2 square is 4. 4 will come up. It will be G M1 M2 upon R square. And this is, if this is F0, I am writing this F0, then new force will be 4 time of F0. This is the answer of fourth part. Now last part, that is question number 5. A solid weigh in air is 80 Newton and volume of 100 centimeter cube. Find the density. Density is nothing, that is mass upon volume. How do you calculate the mass? You know, weight is given 80 Newton is equal to mg. G is 10, m is 80 upon 10. That will be mass is 8 kg. Mass is 8 kg, volume is given, then density can be written as density upon 8 divided by what is volume, that is 100 centimeter cube. Centimeter cube means 10 raised to minus 6 in meters. So that's why you will get it, that is 1000, not 100, this is 1000. This is 1000. 30 will cancel out, it will be 800. Either you can write 10 raised to power minus 3 is left, you can take in numerator, it become 10 raised to power 3.